With an upward motion, the periurethral fascia is penetrated, and the retriever is advanced into the space of Retzius. The retriever captures a suture on the corresponding side of the guide. The notched end is used to ensnare the suture tails. With a downward motion, the retriever needle is withdrawn through the vaginal guide and secured outside the vagina with a hemostat.
結晶板はボールから押し出されます。その結果、結晶板をプラスチックの袋に採集できます。ほとんどすべての結晶板が採集されるまで、サージフェーズと高速の結晶の流れが続きます。
This animation details how optical trapping and holographic optical trapping work. A laser beam from below is focused to a point at the center of the microsphere. In this configuration, each light ray goes straight through the sphere, from bottom to top. Because the sphere does not alter the path of the light rays, no forces are experienced by the microsphere. If the beam is shifted to the left, the microsphere lenses the light to the right. Since light carries momentum, and the microsphere pulls the light to the right, the microsphere is pulled to the left with an equal force. The microsphere is pulled to the left until it is recentered on the light. As the laser is moved from side to side, the microsphere follows the focused laser point. If the beam is focused at the bottom of the microsphere, the light is lensed forward. The microsphere pulls the light upward, and the light pulls the microsphere downward. The microsphere moves downward to center itself on the focused laser point. If the beam is focused above the center of the microsphere, the light is lensed outward, and the microsphere is pushed upward. The laser is typically focused by a microscope's objective lens. By controlling the angle and collimation of the beam as it enters the objective lens, the optical trap and object can be moved in three dimensions. This is accomplished by adding an optical trapping beam to an inverted optical microscope. The microscope uses mirrors and lenses to image the sample on a camera. The laser light for the optical trap is sent through a pair of lenses and is reflected into the objective lens using a dichroic mirror, which reflects the laser light but allows visible light to pass through to the camera. By rotating the optical trapping mirror, the optical trap can be steered right and left in the sample plane. By moving the second telescoping lens, the optical trap can be lowered and raised. The trapped object follows the motion of the optical trap. In holographic optical trapping, HOT, the mirror is replaced with a computer-controlled spatial light modulator, or SLM. The SLM comprises three layers. The bottom layer is a silicon backplane with an array of hundreds of thousands of electrodes. The top layer is an electrically conducting, optically transparent cover glass. Between the backplane and the cover glass is a pneumatic liquid crystal. The orientation of the liquid crystal molecules is controlled by voltages, which are applied to each pixel of the backplane. The molecules align parallel to the backplane for small voltages and perpendicular to it for large voltages. The liquid crystal molecules are birefringent, so as plane waves impinge the SLM, the wavefronts are delayed and shaped according to the hologram pattern displayed. The holograms are calculated so that away from the surface of the SLM, the light from all pixels interferes to create multiple beams of light at varying angles and collimation. These beams are relayed into the microscope objective lens to create multiple simultaneous optical traps. Because the computer-controlled SLM is dynamic and can generate many holograms each second, the optical traps can be dynamically moved in real time. The holographic optical trapping assembly is contained within a compact and robust sub-assembly which can be mounted on a research microscope. Additional holographic traps can be easily added to provide control for a myriad of substances, both biologic and inert. This sub-assembly can also form the core of an automated processing system.
Whole blood is filtered to produce plasma. Plasma is mixed with reagent red cells stored on the disposable. One chamber uses type A cells, while another chamber uses type B cells. If the plasma contains A or B antibodies, they bind to the red cells of that type. The solution is transferred to a measurement chamber where the cells bind to patches if the given antibody was present. Optical traps measure binding, revealing which antibodies are present in the blood. All processing, such as plasma extraction, solution mixing, and cell dilution, is done on the disposable. Note that as the whole blood is pumped through the filter region, the cells are removed and clear plasma is obtained.